So qualifying is complete and we're all set for an exciting race tomorrow. Your top three are Hubert Ailot and Jordan King. Goodbye for now then, but we really are just getting started. Make sure you join us again for Lights Out tomorrow. It's raced as we're now moments away.
After the points finish last race, let's aim to keep the momentum going.
So another fantastic victory for Arden today. Tell me, Davide, what was the key to this success?
Although the Formula 2 cars are all the same.
As they make their way down to the podium, there's no denying the strength of the Arden team. Arden aren't afraid to take risks on new talent, and it certainly looks like it. So then, it's time to see how this result affects the Drivers' Championship. It's a good result for Antoine Hubert, who moves further ahead. The grid is all set for the race tomorrow, but before we go, let's quickly remind ourselves of our top three. And here are the driver grid position.
Okay, this is the team's home race.
Thank you.
scoring position.
Brilliant stuff from Charouz today. What a superb victory. Davide, what do you think made the difference here?
I think this race was won thanks to the tire management. You have to remember, it's not just about going as fast as you can. It's about consistency. It's about maintaining your speed.
It's time for those well-deserved celebrations. They may be one of the newer teams to join F2, but the Charouz team have shown they're a force to be reckoned with, taking home the victory. Well done to everyone on the team. After this round of the World Championship, here's how things look in the driver's table. It's a good result for Antoine Hubert, who moves further ahead at the top of the table. Now then, Davide Valsecchi, who would you say was your driver? As we wind down from the excitement of qualifying, here's a look at your top three.
Blogs,
King,
and Guan Yu Zhou.
It's Saturday, and that means we're preparing for today's Formula 2 event here in Spa. As the cars are being prepared, let's join them trackside for the start of what promises to be a terrific race. With that then, let's run through the grid order.
Bloggs lines up on pole position, and starting alongside is Jordan King.
Looking down the rest of the grid, we have Joe, Aitken, Antoine Hubert, and...
Now that we've got some points on the board, let's continue this form and aim for another top 10 finish. See some rain. ETA is about 15 minutes. Thank you. This is your final lap of the race. We're leading our teammate by 23.7 seconds. Hard for that one. Congratulations.
Brilliant stuff from Carlin today. What a superb victory. So, Davide, how exactly did they set themselves apart from the pack today?
I think they kept a cool head. That's why they won today. Smooth, steady, everything bad that happened to them, they handled it calmly and professionally. That's what let them focus on getting the best out of everything else. The car, the strategy, they managed to keep out of trouble the whole way around.
And there you have it, today's winners. Having raised some of the biggest names in F1 to date, Carlin have once again shown their expertise when it comes to recruiting new talent. No doubt today's winners have a bright future ahead of them. They certainly deserve it after today's performance. And now, let's take a look at the driver's standings. The gap at the top of the championship has been cut down after a difficult race for our championship leader. And so, driver of the day then, Davide Valsecchi, who do you think you'd go for?
It's a difficult one, but I got to go for the Carlin driver. They pushed and pushed and found some fantastic performance. It was a pleasure to watch.
And here's how things are shaping up in the team's championship. It was a tough race for our championship leaders, who lose ground at the top of the table. There was also a strong showing from the Uni Virtuosi team today as they make their way up the standings. After all this drama, you'll be mad not to join us for the next race. We hope to see you then. Take care. So qualifying is complete and we're all set for an exciting race tomorrow. Your top three are Giotto, Alesi and Jordan King. With qualifying complete, all that remains is the main event. We'll be live and uninterrupted for the feature race tomorrow, so make sure you join us then. Welcome, everybody, to the heart of Italian motor racing, Monza. We're here with Formula 2 for what ought to be an extravaganza of excitement and action. Let's head to the start line and get underway. Monza is one of the fastest circuits in Formula 2, comprising some very long straights and tight chicanes. The engines spend so long at full throttle, in fact, that engine failures are not an uncommon sight here. On top of that, the 3.6 miles of track, pretty hard on the gearbox too. Turn one at Monza is famous, or should I say infamous, for serious contact and incidents, especially on the opening lap. What are your thoughts on that, Davide?
Yes, this chicane is a tricky one. A lot of time you see the more experienced driver.
Well then, after an exciting session yesterday, let's take a look at how the cars line up. Luca Giotto starts from pole position today, and starting alongside in P2 is Giuliano Alesi. Looking down the rest of the grid, we have King, Boccalacci, Antoine Hubert, and Joe, Correa, Aitken, De Vries, Nikita Mazepin, Ilott, Galeo, Mick Schumacher, Anne Latifi, Delatraz, Tete Camara, Calderon, and Ralph Boschel, Raghunathan, and Bloggs.
After the points finish last race, let's aim to keep the momentum going.
Carlin have pulled off a sublime performance to secure the top step of the podium today. And Davide Valsecchi, give me your thoughts. How did they accomplish this result?
Well, I'm not sure what we just saw, but one thing's for sure. Today's winner has certainly showed they have no fear battling it out on the track. And who can blame them? I don't think I've ever seen someone get through the competition so quickly. Today's race was a sight to behold, and judging from the crowd's reaction, it went down well with the fans as well.
As we can see, it's time for the podium, and I can see the Carlin team underneath our commentary box going crazy as their driver walks out. It was a great win, and it means a great deal to this team. So then, it's time to see how this result affects the Drivers' Challenge. It's a good result for Antoine Hubert, who moves further ahead at the top of the table. And now, Davide Valsecchi, let me ask you, who is your driver of the day?
It's a difficult one, but I got to go for the Carlin driver. They did a great job at getting the most off the tires without losing pace. That's a good skill to have.
And now a look at the team standings. Arden increased their gap over the competition with that result. Another team that excelled today was Dams, who make further progress up the table. Goodbye for now then, but we really are just getting started. The grid is all set for the race tomorrow, but before we go, let's quickly remind ourselves of our top three, which are Bloggs, Joe, and Luca Giotto. Goodbye for now then. So before the off, let's remind ourselves of yesterday's results, the look at the starting grid. Bloggs lines up on pole position, with Guan Yu Zhou alongside. Looking down the rest of the grid, we have Giotto, Hubert, Jack Aitken.
Now that we've got some points on the board, let's continue this form and aim for another...
It's been my privilege over the years to witness a number of great sporting events, and here's another to add to that prestigious list. It's the ultimate treat for any racing driver. We have a new Formula 2 World Champion. So as they climb out of the Carlin team are ready and waiting to celebrate a thoroughly deserved win. And I have to wonder, Davide Valsecchi, just what set them apart from the competition here?
This race, this week, was about one thing and one thing only: consistency. Anyone can be quick for just one lap, but there's a difference between that and being quick every lap, over and over and over. If you can do that, if you can gain ground when your opponents make mistakes, but then not make mistakes on your own, you can just push and push.
It was not the best weekend for our championship leader, and their advantage at the top has been reduced. Now then, Davide Valsecchi, who would you say was your driver of the day?
Let's give it to Luis Del Tras. That was a commanding performance today. Very impressive indeed.
And what a season. Thank you.